Jeff, if you haven't seen or seen the tag, is the founder of Inventory, and that's V-I-N as in wine, because, well, we all love wine. A fabulous app, I believe, that is really going to make anyone's life easier and more fun and more compelling and all those great words. If you download it and start tracking your wine storage and your wine cellaring and your wine drinking needs. And I'm going to, as I get ready to turn it over, if you guys can hear the background, the garbage truck is coming down the alley right now. So we're going to hear a barking dog and a loud noise for a couple of minutes. So I apologize in advance. So with that, Jeff, I'm going to try and let me see if I can mute and turn it over to you for a second.
You're right.
Oh, I can predict these things. The funny thing is, I've been using this BeLive software for a year now, and I don't even know where the mute button is. So,
no worries.
Sorry about that's Panda. She agrees with everything I said about your app. So with that, so we're here to talk about wine cellar technology and really how we can better track and engage with our wine storage. We've done this twice now. Once we talked about how to collect wine and that process, the next kind of how to build the cellar. And now we got to figure out how to track all those bottles. For me, it's a little bit of a challenge with about 100, 120 bottles in my world. You've got a lot more than that. So let's just dive into it.
Yeah.
What is your biggest challenge? I'm just going to just throw down the gauntlet as a collector when you're trying to manage your wines.
So the challenge, it's interesting. I have a large wine cellar and I have 5 wine fridges. And the challenge was born out of the wine fridge. I had a good friend over for dinner. I knew he was coming. I picked the wine that I thought would serve that I knew was his favorite. And the origin story of Inventory is simply I went up to the fridge knowing the bottle was on the third shelf. I at least knew that. Looked at the third shelf, of course, no bottle there. That bottle was not there. I don't know what happened to it. Now I was in a bit of a mode because I looked at the fourth and the second, neither there. Fifth, sixth, first, couldn't find that bottle. Then I became a little bit panicked that, this was the bottle I had been thinking about for a few days now and was going to decant. Started pulling them out again, and my fridge is a bit packed, and a bottle fell off the edge of the shelf, smashed on the floor. And you know what red wine is like on the floor? It was a hard tile floor.
Beautiful, beautiful, right? It's just, it's like abstract art.
Right. And then I looked at the bottle, and lo and behold, it was the very bottle that I had been searching for. It had rolled off and fallen and smashed, and so I was no further ahead, very frustrated. And so the biggest challenge I see, I just sort of look back and I said, I had the same problem in my wine cellar. I know which bottle I think I want. I walk down into my cellar and I spend probably 10 minutes in there and never usually come up with the bottle I intended to go down and get, because I never really did find it. I knew roughly where it was. I originated by having my cellar organized on beautiful vintage view racks, by the way, but organized by country and then by varietal. And that worked well for about a month, because then you get new bottles in and you're not putting everything over. So you start putting bottles here and there. And eventually I lost track of my cellar. And I realized that all my friends who had cellars lost track of their cellars. Nobody knew, except for the most OCD people, knew where their bottles were. And so we had to develop a way to find bottles in a wine cellar, in a wine fridge.
Yeah. So that's really, that's interesting, because your scale is a little bit different than mine. I'm assuming your buying habits are a little bit different than mine in terms of just, volume as well. Whereas I have, 100 some odd bottles, but my problem is since I don't have a cooled environment, I've got my really good bottles down in a crawl space so that they can sit in a good environment. And my medium and not everyday drinkers in a different area, and I forget what I have where because they're disjointed, especially in the cellar. I never know what the heck's down there because they're all in dusty boxes and all that stuff.
I had a conversation with somebody who wanted inventory because they had gone in their cellar and they had boxes and wine all over the floor at this point. And as they were trying to prepare for inventory, trying to think they're going to get organized, they found 3 bottles of Lafite behind that they didn't even know they had. Not that it was bad, but they didn't even know they had those bottles.
And okay, that's a problem I will never have. If there's Lafite in my cellar, I will know it's there. I will probably put a webcam on that.
But considering that people insure their cellars now and so on, yeah. I know they have the high value, these high-valued wines in their cellar. I was a bit surprised. You know, I showcase if I have that.
There's a lot of technology that's sort of been out there to help with this, right? And I know some people use spreadsheets and they use desktop-based, you know, computer programs and such like that, and some other apps. Talk to me a little bit about how the technology that you guys have developed is a little bit different and really, you know, helps solve the problem so you don't go cranking through bottles and break one.
So I was a spreadsheet user. I had my bottles neatly organized on a spreadsheet. Loved it. I used to spend time just looking at my spreadsheet. I was so proud of it. But spreadsheets are only as good as you keep them updated. And, you know, you get bottles. What do? You don't run to your desk and put them on your spreadsheet. You put them in your cellar. I'll get to it tomorrow. I'll add these times. And you forget the spreadsheet gets out of whack. Something happens on the computer. It just didn't ever really – and everyone's had that experience. And not to mention I was duplicating the spreadsheet and creating a copy when my computer crashed. So I decided, you know, listen, I need to look at apps. I started using apps, was completely disenfranchised with almost every app that was out there. Just didn't meet my needs. And my son at the time, you know, is an engineer, software engineer, had graduated in artificial intelligence and a master's in entrepreneurship. And I said, you know, find me a solution. So we went through a number of solutions. I thought, initially I explored RFID, radio frequency identification, putting passive tags on bottles, thinking I was going to put a big reader or something outside the door. But bottles of wine are unique. The fluid in the bottle, metal racks, glass, all scatter the signal. Didn't really work. And the reader was extremely expensive if you really wanted to pick up RFID. Then that was a problem. I then explored Bluetooth because I thought, here, you could use your phone, put Bluetooth tags on each bottle. The Bluetooth beacons are about $5 a piece, looking at all the bottles you have. So that in that case, the broadcast, the transmitter was expensive. The reader, the phone was simple. So lastly, we decided we would look at augmented reality back from the old Pokemon days long ago. And we developed a proprietary technique that we patented to use augmented reality in a cellar to really look through your phone and see your bottles and overlay on that reality where that bottle is, a marker to show you exactly in your cellar or fridge where that bottle is.
So that really solves, in my mind, the problem, because if you've got a case of Lafite, let's use that as an example, because it's fresh on our mind, and you just got it from your auction house and you go to your beautiful vintage wine racks, because why would you store wine in anything other than vintage, right? Mm-hmm. But you've only got, you've got a scattered 12 slots just all over the room because that's just what you got left. Right. And you don't feel like doing much with that because you don't want to move 1,000 bottles. So you basically can tag them with the phone, your phone, you know, and then it just locates, oh, where are my Lafites? And it's going to just show you the locations. And you might have 12 scattered locations, take one off, no big deal, you know, where the other 11 are. So that's really cool. How does that work with my basement dusty box solutions?
It works. We've developed solutions for everything, for the fridge, for different shelf configurations in a fridge, for every kind of rack, for every box on the floor, every display rack. We've gone through what we think is every opportunity, but and then I'll get something from some collector say, look at this morphed out cellar, and then we have to redesign it. So we've covered off 99.9% of situations, and I think we've done a good job in that. It's fairly interesting. I mean, you can, in the next version, for example, say, show me in my cellar all my Cabernet Sauvignons. And they'll light up multiple points throughout your cellar where you've hidden all your Cabernets. I could take those 12 Lafites, and even though they're in different spots, I could say, show me all my Lafites. And it'll pinpoint simultaneously all the spots in the cellar where those Lafites are. So you can do everything. Show me everything that pairs with red. Show me all my whites beyond that. Reds, my one single vintage 2014. So I could find anything in my cellar with a click of a button.
The 14 would be very, very good for me. That's my wedding anniversary, which is coming up. And I definitely stockpile a lot of 2014s just so I can, my wife doesn't care. I'm nuts. But so I drink the bottle by myself. But I have to go and figure out where my 2014s are stashed, in whether it's boxes on my racks or somewhere in between. So that would be very helpful. Yeah. All right. So one of the things that I have found with any app, and I don't think yours is, you used to probably start to think about this, right? So it's one thing to use the technology, and I've used your technology and I love it, right? That was why we started having this conversation, because I thought it was cool and I started using it. But like, how do you keep the people engaged so they, because you still have to, going back to the spreadsheet thing, right? You still have to actually update it, right? It's not going to magically know what just came in your mail, though, if you can figure that piece out. that'll be, but like, what other things are you guys doing to make sure that people want to like actually open this app up, other than, I mean, obviously the ease of use is great, but what else you got going?
So there are a few things. I mean, we don't want to get out of our lane too far. So we are a seller management app. So we certainly allow people to quickly onboard their wines, take a photo image recognition, put the wine in a spot, take the wine out. It automatically de-inventories it. As soon as you pull it out and consume it, there's consume notes. We have wish lists, for example, in the app. So, for example, you're out, you're with some friends, or you're at a store or a wine tasting. You want that bottle. You don't want to buy it now. You want to take a photo of it, put it in your wish list. Or you're out with friends at dinner, you order a bottle of wine, you like that bottle, you like the scenario, you take a picture of the label, stores it, and you can take up to 10 pictures of your friends who are with you at the table and store that, almost like a journal or a diary of what you've done. We do that. We have other notes in there, for example, consume notes, what my